Hey, hi. Do you know that very particular water ripple effect in Half-Life software renderer? No? Fine, skip to the next section. But if you have, well, did you know you can actually have something similar in OpenGL? If you know graphics programming, of course. That's right, I figured out a way. Step 1, get every water surface in the map, like read the BSP or find out some other way. Step number 2, create a mesh to replace each surface with like your custom water thing. And step 3, render your custom thing with the appropriate texture and a special shader. The secret sauce here is, in fact, the shader. That alone deserves its own video, but in a nutshell, I'm just doing some fancy water ripples and then applying a pixelation effect on the entire thing. Pretty stupid simple if you ask me. In theory, you could even replicate what the very original effect did, and that is to modify the texture in real time. This can be done with compute shaders, but I decided to go for the frankly simpler thing. I hope to work on this more once I have the time, because right now it only spawns a water surface in the middle of the map, and not much else. At that point, we may see a more detailed video about this thing. Also, welcome back to Status War 56, the series where I talk about random things. I'm currently experimenting with a new format. Hope you like it. You know what else is kinda cool? The smoke in Counter-Strike 2. Someone did it in Godot, and me being me, I was like, can I do it in Gold Source? FYI, that's a rhetorical question. I wrote a mini particle system, wrote some basic ray casting code to detect when a bullet hits a smoke sprite, and I just used the engine's built-in rendering API to actually render the stuff. A few things could be improved though. Namely, I'll need to sort the smoke sprites by their distance to the camera, so that they can render in order and not in front of each other. Transparency is, a bit of a pain in graphics programming. It's probably gonna be one of the two or three banes of existence for decades to come. As for the rest, well, it's really just a matter of optimizing this stuff so it can run at least 5 times as fast. We could do SIMD, we could do multi-threading. I mean, heck, this could be entirely GPU-based. Like, I believe Counter-Strike 2 does it, although Counter-Strike 2 does a voxel grid, I believe, instead of a whole bunch of sprites floating around. I mean, certainly it does, it has to. Do you know Half-Life was allegedly meant to have moss that grew on walls? Well, either that or Gaben was just trying to find another way to attract attention to the game. Well, it doesn't matter nowadays because, oh boy, we have the technology, don't we? A year ago, I made a video called 16 Minutes of Real-Time Moss in Half-Life, and that was quite a success. Surprisingly, a lot of the views came from Knockout. That's what actually got me to register there. But anyway, I am soon planning to return to that little project and to try taking it further. So if you just stand in one place for long enough, you can actually like travel across a couple of maps and you'll see that the moss has expanded like that far. It's a little tougher to do, but it can totally be done, I think. Maybe. I actually don't know. All right, now we're in the game review part of the video. I've been playing some Arma 3 recently with the fellas, and you can find some of that footage in this video here. The game is very damn buggy, but with the right mods, it can also be very damn fun. Also, it uses stencil shadows? Immediate 10 out of 10 from me. Period. Doom 2016, oh boy, this game is super duper cool. id Tech 6 is really showing off its capabilities here, and wow, it runs super buttery smooth on my rig. Gameplay is cool, but I feel I'm gonna like start noticing patterns and get bored, and that's not a very good thing. But overall, I mean, I like it so far. It's definitely a 9 out of 10. Like, it's not a straight 10 because, well, there's a few intrusive, like, popping up UI elements that I don't really care about, and like, I just overall feel it's, I don't know, too modernized for my liking, but that's a nitpick, really. Alright, so remember how I said I had a job in the last Status 456? Well, I underestimated how much time it would take away from me, so my schedule has been all over the place, but it's alright. Things are calming down now, and I am slowly finding more time to work on other things. HLSDK Programming 4.2 Hitscan Weapons is probably gonna be out by late October. Also, I figured out some sort of schedule for these status videos as well. Namely, I formed what I call an upload calendar, where status 456 videos are going to happen every 4 months. In this case, April, August, and December. So yeah, 3 times a year. I think that's reasonable. I think it's a reasonable time period with lots of stuff to cover each time, so it doesn't get in the way of the programming series. Unrelated to that, you may potentially notice something different about my voice, and yeah, my younger bro has moved out into his own room, so now that my room is a lot emptier, it has a lot more reverb going on. Right now, I'm like recording this, I'm sitting on the floor, I'm in this weird corner where like my bed is in front of me, I'm carrying a blanket around me, and I'm like, I tried to find like the very best spot which had the least amount of reverb. I'll be looking into acoustic treatment later, and I'm definitely getting a higher quality microphone, like the Rode NT1A. I think it's about time, maybe, I start looking into that sort of stuff. Now, in other news, I got a Logitech G29 steering wheel and a shifter. Back when I was generally new to the internet, like age 7 or 8, I saw these videos of the Logitech G25 and I was absolutely enchanted by it. I wanted it so bad. And a couple years later, when I understood that like the internet has, you know, shops and stores, I managed to find out the price of a Logitech G27 over here in Bosnia. It was 600 Bosnian marks, or maybe 700, I don't remember. To 10-year-old me, that was the equivalent of, let's say, $60,000. That's like a car. It was way, way out of my reach. There's like no way I was gonna get that. And finally, 10 years later, I got my hands on a used Logitech G29 and a shifter for even less than that. Probably one of the very best additions to my arsenal. Now, I know what your old direct drive wheel owners are gonna say. This is a toy for kids, feedback but without the force. Yeah, I getcha, but look, I don't care. Now, my plan in the somewhat near, maybe somewhat far future is to make a Half-Life mod where you can actually drive cars with this thing specifically. I mean, yeah, I'm just obsessed with driving simulators, but I really wanna try doing something like this. So, LG right now is basically some kind of game engine. It's built as a game in Godot. Godot launches LG, and LG has its own systems to behave like an engine. I have been brainstorming some more ideas about how I'll approach visibility in the engine. Last time, I said I would look into something like octrees to subdivide levels, as I definitely won't be using BSP. BSP is simply not very adequate for the kinds of levels I want to make, and frankly, it's like prone to leaks and other things. We can do without that nowadays. But then I found something that may work much better, like better than octrees for me at least, because it's a lot similar. And weirdly enough, Minecraft uses a similar concept. Chunks. Big imaginary cubes, which in my case can also contain smaller imaginary cubes, which store visibility data. Now, you Minecraft modders and everybody else, feel free to correct me, but as far as I'm aware, Minecraft is basically like, you have a chunk which is like a bunch of mini voxels inside. Voxels, not mini voxels. And like it's just that each voxel represents a type of a block. It stores an ID inside or something. And in my case, you can imagine that, except each voxel stores visibility data. So it's like, oh, I can see this chunk from here. I can see this chunk from there. I can see that chunk from there, not this chunk from there. Whatever, you get the idea. Other than that, I've been looking into experimental light mapping technology, which could allow me to create a single light map texture, but with dynamic shadows baked into it for like any time of day. Effectively, it would be some sort of day-night cycle, but in light map form. If you know what Valve's self-shadowing bump maps are, this is kind of a similar concept. It's just done way differently. And that would be it for this episode of Status 456. Also, did I tell you I recently got a VR headset?